food science is all about what's the next thing I can't do, and then trying to get there. Looking for the thing that I am not able to do and making that my next target. You can run 100 meters, well, can I now run 2? Can I now run 3? Can I run 4? How long do I keep doing this till I can run a marathon?
Since coming to Challoners, I've been able to start other projects that I wouldn't take before, I wouldn't take that leap. And it's really helpful because given the chance to do the work that you actually want to do, but it will push you and it's not something that's within like your comfort zone.
Let's face it, you're carrying computers around with you all the time in your pocket, and year on year you're getting more fantastical things that they can do that you never thought would be possible. And people have got to make those apps up and realise the potential. Because, well, we're doing this now, or what could we do in the future? In the same way that I could get my spreadsheet to do this now, what else could I get it to do?
It's about being able to think independently in a sensible, constructive way to solve problems.
I find it really rewarding. Once you get past the first like building block of learning, you can kind of get to a point where you can accelerate your own self-learning.
Sometimes you'll get an error message occurring because it hasn't quite worked, but you're thinking, yeah, actually, let's look at what it says, let's interpret what the error was, and let's see if I can fix it. There are a lot of skills you can learn from teaching IT. Most of the things that I've learned are about how a spreadsheet works. I'm a big fan of the spreadsheet as a result of teaching IT.
The benefits to computer science students later on mainly revolve around their ability to work independently and massively around their perseverance.
Stuff you get out of it can also be applied to like other subjects, so like being able to answer longer problems and go through step by step and decompose a problem and go down and actually solve the little bits of the problem could be applied to a ton of different subjects.
The ability to break down a problem and move to a solution rather than giving up on the instant of hearing answers. I don't know, someone come and give me the answer.
Questions that come up, how do I do this? And I sometimes just don't know the answer, and it's that learning journey of, I don't know, but shall we go and find out? You realise that I can apply to absolutely anything you're doing, not just need a bit of information to communicate and then do some calculation and get an end product from all your inputs is crucially important. And then when we go on and start to teach boys about how to program using something like Python, you're effectively using the same things. It's just bunching together a load of inputs and then working out what you want the computer to do with that at the end. So
once you get to a particular level that you're able to help others, you can apply it to lots of things and be able to answer, say, like big, long questions in exams and explain yourself well.
One of these features that I'd also like, because that would be useful and it can be done, so I will go and find out how to develop my program or calculation or whatever it is that you're doing and add deeper levels of sophistication to get to a better answer at the end.
It's down to the individual learning journey. What do you want to do? What do you want to achieve? What are you going to try next? Rather than just me telling people what to do.